Ctrl+Alt+Make, as the program defines itself, it's supposed to be in a controlled environment, how alternate learners take to making. And it's always from the point of inquiry of how do you really build stuff? How do you make stuff? And we have designed very clearly that there are 7 parallel tracks that's running, and so that there is a choice for these children to pick up whichever that they would like to attend, at least to get as a teaser info about what each of these tracks are doing. On day one, we invited fellow makers from the community to meet, greet and share their work with the participants to help them open out to the world of making. In fact, the range of makers were from bamboo woodworks to someone who built a unicycle, self-balancing unicycle, a low-fill bassinet, an augmented experience of music, a robot, a basic kit that would help students be introduced to robotics, a young app developer who showcased her skills to help find good domestic help in the city, to Zmote, a smart home automation, UnoCoin, a digital currency, and last but not least, a gesture-controlled robot from Invento. The range did help set the context for the following 2 days for the workshop.
Skill sets are available, plenty of them are available. All you have to do is go in search. And all you have to do is become best in what you do.
So in the last 10 years, we've all been participating in the third industrial revolution. Now from here, things are going to change. And we are going to get into the fourth industrial revolution. The fourth industrial revolution is happening now. But I want to share with you 5 points which are my reflections on learning. What I have experienced through life, and I hope it will be of some use to you.
Right after guest speakers shared their experiences, 7 facilitators jumped in pitching their sessions. We had 3D printing, computer-aided design, biohacking, coding debunked, IoT, woodwork, and AR/VR. 7 tracks ran parallel over a day and a half, providing all participants a choice of 3 tracks to sign up for as introductions. The 3D printing facilitator had a 4-step approach to his session. He called it the 4 elementary steps, beginning with obtaining a 3D model, be it a ready file from the internet, then converting to get it as an STL file, followed by slicing the STL file and obtaining a G-code, and lastly, uploading the G-code to the 3D printer. The IoT session served as a gateway to the world of everything smart. Fundamental queries regarding what, why, and how of IoT were answered. Arduino versus Raspberry debates were debunked. Further, hands-on with sensors, microprocessors, microcontrollers led to a handy Wi-Fi controlled light switch harnessing the power of IoT. A lot of mystery surrounding the realm of augmented reality and virtual reality had to be unraveled before getting a firm grasp of it. Going with the thought, the session was split into 2 parts. Part 1 was where the facilitator took time out to explain the technical nuances involved, and the session translated in the experience with AR/VR gears during part 2. From visualizing a cell without a microscope to preparing leaf skeletons by dissolving proteins, biohacking proved to open new ways of looking at biology. This track certainly kept the participants' sensorial experiences to heights in understanding the sciences to hack at best with everyday objects. Session on coding was centered around comprehending logic and translating the very logic into understanding code. Math was brought in and analogies were extended from it to code for easy understanding. Choosing to write an algorithm for a calculator, the facilitator was able to truly debunk the myths of coding for these youngsters. Encouraging participants to reimagine and design their learning spaces, the facilitator introduced them to computer-aided design. During the course, participants dabbled with some of the Google SketchUp tools to understand and visualize objects in 3D and then slice it down to 2D, and vice versa, giving them an inside-out perspective to CAD. By far, woodwork was the most hands-on session from our stable. It gave the participants the fundamentals of how woodworking was done. Safety protocols, introduction to tools, machines, best practices, attention to ergonomics and design was the core of it. The bonus takeaway was that every participant made a wooden toy that had kindled the spirit of the child by the end of it. Day 3, parallel tracks continued till midday. Last session of the program was given to the participants to brainstorm within their school groups on everyday problems that they would like to address with the use of technology. Students mind mapped on 5 W's and 1 H. The why, what, where, when, who, and how of the problem statement to arrive at possible solutions for presentation and feedback.
No matter what the background is, no matter what the gender is, nothing will actually matter here other than your ideas and passion. Yeah.
In terms of an exposure to the kind of things that one could do with their own bare hands as against the conventional technology that we get to see, I think there's a lot one gets to learn. A lot of technology related has been demystified. You know, for example, she wouldn't have even thought about IoT for that matter. I mean, she'd just watch it on the television or on YouTube, and now all of a sudden she knows that it's something that she can just reach out to and do it on her own. I mean, she didn't even think about 3D printing. It was that accessible as a printer is today. Yeah, and I think that way it was a very enriching experience.
I thought to do my own maker space in my school and in my home, and call all the friends and explain them.
We love Workbench Projects!